Hello everyone. What I'd like to show you how to fix now is the keyboard setting on the lock screen if you're using a keyboard that has a language other than the language that you're using for the rest of the operating system. So that's the case for me. I've got a German keyboard because I want access to those sweet, sweet umlaut characters in the Scharfes S, but I'm not good enough at German yet that I can really, you know, use the operating system on a daily basis in German. So I've got a bit of a transitioning period. And one thing that's annoying for me right now is that I use the German keyboard full time, but on the lock screen, the language is set to English. And you see here, I've got other languages set up, but you know, I really want the German keyboard to be the default in the lock screen so I don't have to always come down here and click it. You know, those keyboards have different layouts, and trying to enter your password with the wrong keyboard, especially if you're using special characters as you should, then it's annoying, right? You just have to change it every time. And that's what we're going to fix. So I'll go ahead and log in. There's a couple different ways to get to one of the menus that we're going to look at, and it doesn't really matter which route you take. So one option is to click down here where the language is displayed and you go into language preferences. I'll just show how to get there from the start menu. So we click start, click on the gear icon for settings, and then go to time and language. And then I'll come down to language. So I've installed two different versions of English here. You see traditional English and simplified English. In the United States options here, you see I've got the US QWERTY keyboard installed, and that's the only one I want installed under US English because I'll use that for coding later. Now, if I go to English UK under options, you see I've installed the German QWERTY keyboard, and the US QWERTY keyboard is also there, and the US Dvorak keyboard is also present. So I've got five different combinations here, right? And they're all displayed in this menu. So the three different languages that I've set up are United States English, United Kingdom English, which itself has three different keyboards installed. And then there's German language with a German keyboard. Now what I want on the lock screen is a German keyboard in every case. I also want to set up my default language to be UK English because the date format makes sense there, and also the units for things like Word and stuff match the whole rest of the world. So I want that to be my default language. So I'll go to Windows Display and select English United Kingdom, and it's going to update that after the next sign in. That's fine. Now you see these two items got changed automatically, but the region format didn't. Now where do I go to touch that? Well, it jumped me into a new menu, but it's the same as just going up one. Region format, I want to change to United Kingdom. So that's fine. I'll go back. Whoops, that's too far back. Now under language, you see that regional format has been changed to UK English. And now I've got it everywhere, right? Except under speech, but I'm not going to mess with that now. So now if I go to administrative language settings and under copy settings, I have to give in my admin password. Now you see here it says display language, input language is English UK with a German keyboard, right? And then you would click copy your current settings, that is the current user's settings, to the welcome screen and system account. And then you see that the welcome screen would be changed to German. Now, if I hit OK, that will work. But if you're watching this video, it's because for some reason this hasn't worked. And I'm going to show you why that is. I think the reason is that when you have a language set up and the keyboard is not already part of this language, it's not installed here, for example. So remember in US English, if I go to options, I've only got the QWERTY keyboard installed, not the German one. It says the keyboard language is English United States. So let's try to adjust that setting again. Administrative language settings, copy settings, log in again. Okay, and so now if I copy my current settings to the welcome screen, you see that it just, you know, copies this US English, US keyboard combination. And that's not solving my problem, right? So under this button, keyboard, if I pick UK English with a German keyboard here and I override the default, which is to just take the first item in the list, then I hit back and you see the keyboard is now English United Kingdom, but it's abbreviated, right? It's actually a German keyboard in the background. The keyboard setting says English UK, but it's really English UK display language with a German keyboard. Now, if I go to administrative language settings, I'll copy settings. I got to log in again. Now you see that option is available again, right? The input language, the one I manually selected, is English United Kingdom with a German keyboard, despite this display language being English from the United States, right? And now if I copy this to the welcome screen, it will work. So let's just do that this time. I'll hit OK. OK. And now I'll press Windows L to lock the screen. If you had just freshly installed a new language pack, it would probably tell you that you need to do a full reboot. But the process is the same. Once you get back to the lock screen, then it should be fixed. And now you see, right? I've got English with a German keyboard as my first option. So I don't have to change anything. I can just log in directly using my German keyboard, and it's working as I would like it to. And the setting sticks. It's a bit weird that there are a couple different ways to achieve this, right? So here I've gone through and manually selected the keyboard that I want to use, which that's probably what I'll end up doing, because I just want to make sure that it doesn't change unless I tell it to change. But if I were to go back to use the recommended language list, then I'd have this same problem again, right? If I go to log in English United States under the US language, I've only got the one keyboard installed, and that's the one that will be available by default on the lock screen. However, if I choose UK English and move it up, and we look down here in this menu, now you see the first option available is UK English with a German keyboard. And under keyboard here, English United Kingdom, use language list recommended. That means it's going to take this first option. At least that's my interpretation. And you see it here again, right? So in that case, it does work. But you might see now how it's easy to accidentally change this setting without really noticing what you're doing. And that's why I'm just going to choose this keyboard deliberately, so that I always know this is the lock screen keyboard that gets used, despite however I decide to order these languages. So that's it. I just wanted to show you that there's sort of a hidden setting in this little drop-down menu, which is setting up the default input method for the current user. That is the setting that gets copied when you go into administrative language settings and then copy settings. You give in your password, and when you come here, the input language setup that you've got, that's the one for the current user in that drop-down menu that we just looked at. That's the thing that would get copied if you select this tick box, which is what the other tutorials will tell you to do, but they don't always mention that you need to have it set up here as well as the default setting for that user. That's the thing that gets copied around. So that's it. I hope that helped you finally get this annoyance dealt with on the lock screen, and I thank you for watching.